In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to fit linear regression models consisting of single and multiple predictors. When constructing these types of models, predictors could be either numerical, categorical, or a combination of both. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using the empty cars dataset from the R datasets package in the Rguroo repository. The categorical variables I'll be using have been properly reclassified and labeled in the variable type editor prior to performing this analysis. If you would like assistance loading this dataset or learning more about classifying variables, please watch our video, Variable Type Editor. From the Analytics pane, scroll down to Analysis, and then click on Linear Regression. This will open the Linear Regression dialog box. Here's where you can construct a simple or multiple regression model for the empty cars dataset. Let's start by going over the linear regression layout, though. The response dropdown gives you access to all numerical variables that exist in the selected dataset. I'm going to choose miles per gallon represented by MPG for my response. You could also simply type in the name of the response variable if you already know it. The formula text box is where you specify the linear predictor or predictors for the response. We refer to this as the predictor portion of the model. Over to the right, the variables box is populated with a complete list of all variables from the dataset, both numeric and factor. By double-clicking on any variable here, it will instantly be added to the formula box to the left. Let's double-click on the horsepower variable, which is represented by HP. And now we have successfully set up a simple linear regression model. Easy, right? But what if you wanted to add more variables? As you can see, double-clicking on multiple variables creates a little bit of a mess, and Rguroo won't be able to recognize this as a set of multiple predictors. Let's clear this out and start over. In order to perform a multiple linear regression, you will need to use the syntax that you would use in the programming language R to specify the prediction portion. Let me help you out by giving you a few examples. Double-click on horsepower again, but this time hit the plus key or button, and then scroll down and double-click on the weight variable WT. We have now structured the model to have both horsepower and weight as predictors for miles per gallon. If you wanted to add an interaction effect between horsepower and weight, click on the plus button again, redouble-click horsepower, hit the colon button, and then redouble-click back on weight. Underneath the formula text box, we will see what's called the weight dropdown. This is used to specify weights in case of a weighted regression. This dropdown will consist of numerical variables from the dataset, and it is important to note that only variables whose values are non-negative can be used as weights. By default, all cases are weighted equally and with a weight of 1. The Include Diagnostics Table checkbox and the ID variable dropdown are related to a diagnostic table in your output. We will talk more about these in another video titled Added Features and Diagnostic Tools for Linear Regression. And lastly, the By Group dropdown on the top right of the dialog box includes all factor variables from the dataset. If a factor variable is selected, then a separate regression analysis will be carried out for each level of the factor. Since we are ready to perform this multiple regression analysis, let's hit the preview icon. By default, Rguroo's output consists of all cases used in the analysis, the regression coefficient estimates, the R squared values, an analysis of variance or ANOVA table, a residual versus fit plot, and a normal probability plot of residuals. If you would like to further explore the various types of R syntax used for linear regression, and in particular specifying the predictor part of the model, we invite you to visit www.rdocumentation.org. If you would like more examples on how to implement simple or multiple regression in Rguroo, please reference the chapter Linear Regression from our user guidebook.